So, as I mentioned, sometimes inside SharePoint, you may want to create more than one of a default list. It may be necessary, for instance, for you to create more than one calendar because you want to track specific deliverable dates for more than one project, and you don't want to mix those dates together inside the same calendar. So, you need to create a calendar. To create a calendar, we need to do one of two things. You can select Lists in the Quick Launch and click Create, or you can go to Site Actions and choose More Options. Whatever method you choose, you end up here at the Create dialog where you need to select List, which filters out all of the other items that are available to you and places you in an alphabetical list of all the lists that are available. We select Calendar, and once we've selected it, the name box pops up with a brief description telling you what the calendar is and what the calendar does, and the More Options button. If we click More Options, we notice that under the name is Description and other options like Navigation and Group Calendar. But we want to focus on things that absolutely have to be done, and you absolutely have to name everything you create inside SharePoint. So we're going to go ahead and we want to name it something different so we can tell it apart from the other calendar. We're going to call this the Morale Events Calendar. Now, for the sake of documentation, you might want to create a description that explains the purpose of your calendar. We're going to go ahead and make sure that everybody knows that this calendar tracks morale events for Contoso employees. Here at Contoso, HR is pushing forward a new morale initiative, and this calendar will track those events. Now that we've created a name and we popped in a description, the Create button is active down below, and all you have to do is click Create. We're taken almost immediately to our calendar, and we notice that the calendar ribbon is up and active in case we want to really get rolling to create other views and that sort of thing. The other thing to keep in mind is that we know we're in the Morale Events calendar because there are a couple of places that tell us that immediately. One is in the Calendars view, Morale Events calendar, and the other is under the Lists. Morale Event calendar has been placed in the Quick Launch and it's highlighted. And if we return to Lists and we're looking only at our lists, we can see that the Morale Events calendar has been added to our list with a description and when it was created. So that's how we create an additional calendar inside our SharePoint team site. So over time, people have added new items to this events calendar. We're going to use those to review a number of ways to navigate and to add new items. Now we could select any date, but we'd want to select Monday. So we're going to put our cursor over Monday, and as we do, the Add link appears in the lower right-hand corner. Create a new item or to add it to this date, we would go ahead and click the Add link. It takes us directly to the Morale Events new item calendar, and we could begin creating our item. But first I'd like to point something out. Title, start time, and end time are all required fields. To save this event, we have to have data in those fields. So to that end, let's go ahead and name this event New Employee Orientation. This event is going to occur in Conference Room 132, and it'll be 9 a.m. The end time defaults to an hour later in this case, so we're going to go ahead and accept that. A description, while not necessary, is extremely helpful, so we're simply going to say, during this meeting, we will welcome and train new employees. And to make sure that everybody knows this is a meeting, we're going to choose Meeting from the Category section. So let's check this over. We've got our primary fields, title, start time, and end time, and then we added the location and the description and a category of meeting. At this point, we can go ahead and save this item. When the calendar refreshes, you'll notice that it appears here in Monday the 3rd, and as I put my cursor over the item, it gives me the time, the meeting name, and the location in parentheses. Now that's very Outlook-like. If you've ever done that in Outlook, you know that that's the truth. Now let's go ahead and take a look at some of the other events that we have here. One of our staff members, someone on our team, told me that they had entered an event on Thursday that I don't see on this Thursday. To see what else is on this Thursday, I have a couple of options. My first one is right here in the month view. I can click on two more items. And then there it is, the 3 to 5 p.m. technical setup planning meeting that I had expected to see on Thursday the 6th. However, I can then go ahead and collapse that so that it doesn't take up quite so much space on the calendar. If I don't want to go ahead and use my two more items link, I can select the date by putting my cursor on the title bar of this cell and clicking once. This takes me to that very day, Thursday, May 6th. Then I would scroll down to 3 and 5 where I'm expecting to see the meeting, and I do. Please notice that the calendar ribbon has opened and that we are in day view. We could also look at it in week view, and that too is informative. And then we are working in month view where we've got our two more items link. So now let's create another item. This time it's going to be a multiple day event. Notice that like Outlook, I can go ahead and click on Friday and hold down my mouse button and drag across to Saturday. Then I can put my cursor over Saturday, click the add link, and create a new item for both Friday and Saturday, 4:30 and 5:01. We're creating an event for the Contoso Company Retreat that is going to be occurring in Elm Street Park. The time has been set for us automatically because we pre-selected those dates, but we're going to go ahead and put in a description to help people out, and that's that the festivities occur from 11 to dark on both days. Then we're going to go ahead and make this not a meeting, but rather a get-together. Automatically, this has been made into an all-day event filling both days entirely because we selected the entire days, Friday and Saturday, on the calendar. We can go ahead and click Save. After the calendar refreshes, it goes ahead and puts that company retreat right up there on the Friday and Saturday we chose. Now, notice that as I put my cursor, I still get the call out that gives me the information about the event. So now I'd like to go ahead and show you how to create a recurring event. I'm going to go ahead and come down here and click on Monday the 10th because that's when this event is going to start, and it's going to occur every Monday from now until whenever it ends. We're going to click the Add button one more time, but before we move any further, we need to come down and select Recurrence, which is what repeating events are called here in SharePoint. So we're going to go ahead and click the checkbox in there, and the dialog box changes quite a bit, giving us the option of choosing the recurrence pattern for this event. Well, as I said, we're going to make it weekly. It's going to occur every Monday, and we don't have to have an end date for this item, although we certainly could. Again, a very Outlook-like interface. This is going to be called the Coffee and Fun event, and that meeting is going to take place in Meeting Room 222. It's going to occur really early in the morning. Because this is a morale-building event, we want to give everybody possible the opportunity to attend. Now, we don't need a description, but we do want to call this a get-together. I think the title speaks for itself, so no description necessary. A category of get-together with our weekly already set, and we can go ahead and save that item. Now, you'll notice that because we set this at 8 a.m., starting on the 10th, it appears at the top of the list, or at least above anything that was already there, occurring at 9 a.m., and it continues throughout the month, and we continue into next month, because it is a recurring event with no end date. So that's how we create singular events, and multiple day events, and recurring events here inside SharePoint's calendar.